I've designed a workbook that allows you to receive products on your first receiving sheet, and then it's going to add it to your inventory sheet. And so you can see that I have product A, B, and C here, and that all of my numbers are 1. And so when we press the Receive Stock button here, it first of all deletes all the stuff that we haven't received because now it's being placed in inventory. And then let's go over to here. And there you see we've added products to all of the numbers, and then product D was added, and the cost of that was added as well. So let me show you how I did this. So the first thing I did was I declared values. And so it's based on clicking this button, right? And so then X as long, receiving as a workbook, inventory as a workbook, product number as a string, end row as long, range as RNG as a range, row number as long, and row as long. So X equals 2 because we have heading rows on the top ones. While cells X1, which is the first column, does not equal blank, then you go through this. So we're setting our product number equals to the cell in the X row in the first column. So for each, with the worksheet on inventory, which is where we're going to put it, it's going to search the product number, set string range. The range is what we're looking for, is if we're going to look for the product number in these cells, and we're looking in range AA, so that's all of A. We're looking for product number. Now, so if they find range is nothing, if they don't find the product number on the sheet, then we're going to set the end row, and the end row equals worksheets, inventory, cells 1-1, current region, count 1. So it's going to count to the end row, and then it's going to go to the next one. And so then it's going to copy to inventory cells, the receiving cell. So end row 1, the first column, is equal to receiving sheets X1, and then inventory end row 2, which is the second column, equals to the receiving sheet X2, and the same thing with inventory end row 3 equals receivings X3, and go to end, which is go to end E, which is just before the loop here. There we have end E here. Okay, else, if the row number or range is found, row number equals the range the row number was found on. And so with after the end if and the end with, worksheets inventory cells row number 2 value equals worksheets inventory cells row number plus the worksheets receiving cells X2 value. So it's adding those two values together, and then we increase our loop. Now after we've got all this done and we've got all our inventory in place, then we go through, we go back to the receiving sheet, and I've changed it from X to row so that we wouldn't get confused. And so do while row 1 does not equals blank, and range cells row 1 or column 1 to row column 3 select. So that's all the values that I have in there, and I say selection delete. Now, because we're deleting these rows, you don't need to add 1 to the row number. And then you loop and you do it all over again. So let me run this again. I'll put some more values in there so you can see it run. So I've added some more information to my receiving sheet. I've got product A and product B that I'm adding 4 to. And I've added a new product E. So if we go to our inventory for a second, we notice that we have A and B, we have 4, and we have no product E here. So let's press our Receive Stock button here. And then we'll go and see. So now we have 8 and 8 for product A and B, which is perfect. We have no change in product C and D, and we have product E as it's supposed to be. So that's how you create a receiving sheet that adds products to your inventory. Please subscribe.